Against the backdrop of a declining liberal international order, the rise of geopolitical tensions, and the COVID-19 pandemic, the concept of European strategic autonomy has gained considerable traction.
European strategic autonomy is goal number one for our generation.
But what does the concept mean? It emerged in 2013 in the context of defense and came to be defined as the ability to cooperate with international and regional partners wherever possible, while being able to operate autonomously when and where necessary. The EU is now not only looking to strengthen its autonomy in defense and security, but also in the economic, digital, industrial, and trade domains.
The COVID-19 pandemic crucially exposed the vulnerabilities in the global supply chains and reinforced the perception that the EU industries is falling behind China and the United States in some key sectors. This led to calls for a strengthened resilience and a reduction of one-sided dependencies in areas such as raw materials, critical technologies, and pharmaceutical ingredients.
However, calls for more strategic autonomy are also met with concern.
Some member states were concerned that the strategic autonomy agenda would lead to protectionism, would harm the open economy, and would provide the German and French industry champions, such as in the automobile industry, with an unfair advantage.
In answer to these concerns, the European Commission insisted that its goal is open strategic autonomy, and that this can be achieved without resorting to protectionism. The agenda reflects the EU's desire to reduce its strategic dependencies and protect its industries against economic coercion and unfair trade practices while preserving an open economy. In a recently published report, the Klingendahl Institute unpacked the concept of open strategic autonomy and its implications for industrial and trade policy.
Our analysis shows that the twin aims of strategic autonomy on the one hand and the preservation of an open economy on the other are not necessarily incompatible and may even be complementary. On paper, the European Commission appears committed to a proportional, inclusive, and case-by-case approach, and it is taking conscious steps to improve the international framework of interdependence, such as, for instance, by pushing for the reform of the World Trade Organization.
However, the researchers also found that there remains an inherent tension between the two aims, and the pursuit of strategic autonomy does come with potential trade-offs that ought to be acknowledged.
Externally, some measures such as the carbon tax and the export credit facility could well be perceived as disguised protectionism by the Union's trading partners and could potentially trigger retaliatory responses such as in the form of new tariffs.
It is therefore important that the EU institutions and member states take these trade-offs into account in the pursuit of their open strategic autonomy agenda.
In our report, we recommend that the EU consistently applies the principle of proportionality to its industrial and trade policy. We also recommend that it makes the strengthening of the international framework of interdependence the core component of its open strategic autonomy agenda. And finally, we recommend that it prepares measures to protect itself against potential retaliation.
To learn more, read the Klingendahl report, Unpacking Open Strategic Autonomy from Concept to Practice.